Cupid's second arrow landed on a very unlikely duo.
Oh, we just know it's going to get orgasmic about now.
Okay, they weren't in love, but they did have characteristics of a married couple. There was For Better.
I think it's a good song, and it,
well,
you know,
fine,
we should
well,
be getting behind it now.
I did.
And there was For Worse.
I'm really mad with you about that.
Does that bug you? That bugs me!
Action kicks off at five.
Martin was one of those rare and sacred monsters of radio, a breakfast DJ.
The end, it's all yours.
He followed an honourable tradition of overexcited radio jocks, beginning with the man who started the whole phenomenon, the 60s enigma that was Tony Blackburn.
Hey, 4 1/4 minutes now, past 7 o'clock.
Radio 1 will be this one.
In the late 70s came the larger-than-life hairy cornflake Dave Lee Travis. It was the lads' preserve until the late 90s, when ladettes like Sarah Cox and Zoe Ball took over the mic.
Yes, Zoe Ball here, 36, 26, 39, I'm a Sagittarian.
There was one thing they all shared, huge egos.
We are here at Lakeside for the Valentine's Day Roadshow.
And I'm in the mood for love.
OK, traffic mayhem, expect the worst at Lakeside today. Let's find out how we're looking.
Martin.
One of these days.
Bam! To the moon!
Martin.
His style was very, very crazy, very wacky, very off the wall.
Martin Day, the man with the hair on the air everywhere, live from the Nut Hut. Hey, Einstein, figure this one out. Half of men and two-thirds of women admit to doing this regular-like. What is it?
I was like a cheesy radio DJ trying to be a radio DJ.
Very much the time when bonkers radio and wacky radio existed.
I don't want to say anything.
Oh, you just keep quiet over
Shall
there.
Shall I just shut up?
It's actually dialing 1471.
Stand by for Wham and Freedom. I need some.
Oi, party.
Yo, boss.
The boss had a direct line into the studio.
You're throwing something at Ali, but that's made her sound totally stupid. And it's your fault, Martin, for not actually giving her a line to come back with.
Every time he does something that needs to be corrected, or we need to make sure he doesn't do it again, press the button and talk to him. And yeah, he hated it.
Martin.
And of course you get your £50 spending money as well! Yay!
Martin.
Yeah.
You were just shouting in that.
It was a terrible idea having that system put in, because you'd be in the middle of your radio show and he would come into your ears, so you could actually hear him there and then shout in your ears, you know, you're shouting, or something like that. And when you get that into your ears, that was just awful.
Stop shouting! It's never gonna be perfect!
He had no idea that people possibly might be reaching for the off button.
Martin was summoned to the boss's office.
I don't exactly know what he wants. What the heck did I want from me? 2 years now, I'm still not getting it right.
All by girls, women doing their shopping!
Stop shouting!
There's a difference between shouting and dynamic range. You're wanting to have dynamic range, but you don't have to shout!
Probably because the TV cameras were there, to a certain extent. I think he was really enjoying playing the part of the ogre.
But we need to get Kate doing some more voice training with you.
Oh, no.
No, it's fine.
You know what happened the last time? Oh, I was speaking like that for a week. Oh. I had the bloody BBC World Service on the phone to me day after. God is question time.
Martin Day was the wild boy of the airwaves at Essex FM. He constantly came under fire from radio boss Paul, who battled to keep him in line.
But you shouldn't have played it out without my permission.
I was known for the long hair. I was water-fistled many times, you know, walking down the street with that hair. I'm often mistaken for a girl.
So soft, so shiny.
Feels so good.
Can we just land it?
Yeah, we're going.
Anyway, Martin and Paul's relationship had already been tested in the sky above Essex.
Martin, I'm not doing that. We do actually have a slight problem.
Paul had placed his life in Martin's hands on his maiden flight as a qualified pilot. It was all going really well up to the emergency landing.
Never again.
Going flying with Martin was definitely an act of complete and utter madness on my part.
One Trevor, so be careful, he's going to be cutting your hair.
Style challenge would mean a chance for revenge.
Hi, how are you?
I'm scared.
Just put your hand down there a minute and we'll just lock you in. I don't want you chickening out.
When the handcuffs went on, I thought, I think this means that the hair's going to go.
But there was a bigger surprise for Martin. The boss had arrived.
It was a fantastic opportunity, in my opinion, to get back at him for taking me up in that little rickety plane.
On the show, you've had lots of problems. You've had lots of run-ins, you know, with your boss,
yeah,
haven't you?
Yeah.
Is he a nice guy, or did you just do that for the cameras?
Well, he's not a bad guy. It has to be said, he's not as bad as he makes out.
Really?
But he's the boss, and it's his job to moan and groan at me, and I let him do it because he is the boss.
But you like him? I mean, you know.
Oh, he's a great guy.
Is he?
I don't listen to a word he says, and I ignore him totally, but I feel like I have to let him say what he wants to say, so I just let him moan. I go, ah, 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 and then I come
out. Who do you think's got the scissors, Martin?
No, not a chance.
Martin?
I had no idea at all. No idea. That was a genuine surprise.
This is going to be my revenge for that flight you took me a few weeks ago.
3, 2, 1.
I took great pleasure in chopping off his mullet.
I felt like a big part of me had gone. I'd had long hair for so many years.
When Martin went home that night, his wife Debbie sadly burst into tears because she didn't like his new look.
What have they done to you? You don't look like my Martin anymore.
Martin and Emma!
She had DJ Martin for support as she walked back onto the stage, but after that she was left rather, well, exposed.
The first thing that struck me is when I walked out onto the stage, I saw my dad's face in the audience and he looked absolutely shocked. His mouth was open and I thought, what have I got on? So I'm standing there, I could feel my heart beating before this mirror went round because I just kept thinking, why is my dad looking like that? Why is my dad looking like that?
I actually pointed to her, you know, I can see your knickers. And she was, oh!
Here it comes!
Everything was going through my mind at once. I was thinking, I'm standing here with this dress on and you can see through it.
Emma. Where do I start, really? What do you think?
I love it. It's really different. It's great. I didn't feel like I had the confidence to say, actually, I don't like that dress. I just didn't, so I just lied. I'm gobsmacked. I don't know what to say.
Yeah. Join the club, mate. Join the club.
Presenter John Leslie turned into a quivering wreck.
It's a spin.
And this is the first... No, don't give us a spin.
I was really embarrassed at the way John behaved. It was just... It was awful. Because what can you do? I just kept giggling because I didn't know what to say or what to do. He was just being silly.
Sexy Spice look.
Yeah, it's marvellous.
You like it then? Don't hold back. Don't hold back.
That's good.
But if Emma hated her outfit, she needn't have worried. Have you seen what Martin's wearing?
His outfit, I thought, was ridiculous. But, it, you know, he was prancing about the stage with his guitar and really enjoying himself.
Will you calm down for just a minute?
No, I like this.
Right. So we like that.
Rather amazingly, I can still get into those trousers that I got on Style Challenge. I still have them, and I still love that costume. I've worn it a few times at fancy dress, actually, when I've gone to places as rock god with a big studded belt. It's great. It's a fantastic outfit.
So did TV fame propel the rock god to the pinnacle of DJing when filming ended? Did it inspire him to seek his fortune outside Essex?
In terms of this morning, not a lot.
And has he ever forgiven Paul over the hair thing?
Wait! Friday! And you know what that means!
Of course he didn't. He's still Essex FM's resident breakfast DJ. Except now he has company in the form of Sue and the Morning Crew.
Do you know, I've always been just happy where I am. I've never been a greedy guy, and maybe to my detriment, I've never really been a very ambitious guy either.
Friday morning, Essex FM with Martin and Sue and the Morning Crew. It's Alanis Morissette, it's ironic, it's Essex FM.
But you know, apparently I could have become a lot famouser, if that's a real word. and I could have made loads of money. Is that true?
You may have heard of us. We're very famous. Well, I am. I was once on the telly, you know. Oh, yes. It's a very popular show. It was called Lakesiders. Do you remember that?
You had more hair back then, didn't you?
I had slightly more hair.
And what about Paul? Did Martin drive him to distraction and out of the studio? He did spend a couple more years trying to control the DJ.
Martin?
Yeah?
You were just shouting in that.
But then he left the station to become a radio consultant and hasn't seen Martin since.
Now, the South End Festival is on now. The big finale is going to be on Sunday, the Essex FM Motion.
Today, he has his eye on the new generation of DJs.
One of the things I do, ironically, is I train young DJs to do breakfast shows and be on the air and get better. And I also train young program controllers how to develop their relationship with the with their on-air talent. Thank and it all started from Lakesiders.
He played it yesterday as well, did he? Mm-hmm.
And here's an example of how not to do it.
Her words, quote, "You are doing your own private pirate plays."
But today, he's got a very important meeting.
You like common? I'm council through and through! Songs from Martin Day's random iPod. It's Friday, time to pick song number 3. I'll leave the crew up to that.
And I said we've got a little surprise for you. So instead of us picking the song, we've got somebody who we felt was probably more qualified than this. And therefore, here he is.
How's it going, Martin?
You're going to explain my
I have in the studio with me Paul Chantler, was my boss many years ago. In fact, to me, he'll always still be the boss.
You're not winging it anymore for in program
preparation? Look at all this. Look, I've been up all night preparing and today's show.
You're not shouting at listeners?
Shouting, no! I haven't shouted on the radio for years!
Okay, well, we're going to give you the choice of any song you like.
Well, there was an Aerosmith song, wasn't there, that you were keen on at the time, I seem to remember.
I remember, rather stupidly, waving a lighter from side to side.
Know it's going to get orgasmic about now.
So Aerosmith, don't want to miss a thing.
Sounds great.
Would that be all right?
You two hugging and crying and things like that while this is going on.
Oh, give us a hug, big fella.
I could spend my life in this sweet surrender. I could stay lost in this moment.
We do actually have a slight problem.
Yeah, we had fun, we nearly crashed.
We got the microphone.
There's a moment.